3 months to the 5th anniversary of promulgating the constitution and the 5-year deadline to fully implement the constitution, the Office of the Auditor General has released an interim report detailing the socio-economic impact of the constitution following an audit request by the National Assembly's Budget Committee. It is this report that Mandera Senator Bill Okero claims to be privy to the recommendations, which he says will not be delivering good news to the senators.
And one of the recommendations that is coming out is the abolition of the Senate. One option. The second recommendation that is likely to come out and which is being discussed is if it's not going to be abolished, then it should be elected by the council assemblies rather than the people. So I think the National Assembly, there is little doubt that there are members there who sincerely have very little regard for devolution.
Kero claims the recommendations are part of a well-orchestrated plot to reverse the constitutional gains in setting up a bicameral house. His allegations, however, contradict with that of the Auditor General, who says there is need to enhance the role of the Senate as representative of counties and county governments.
Amend the constitution and require the senators to be elected through constituent assemblies that are constituted at the county level.
This audit on social and economic factors should look at the work of the senator and the governor and their relationship, and also the issue of the county government vis-a-vis the senator. At the moment, those issues are not very, very clear.
The Auditor General, who appeared before the National Assembly Budget Committee, interestingly claimed there is no correlation between the high public wage bill to the implementation of the constitution. He, however, could not justify the cost of the taxpayer to sustain the current 11 Constitution Commission. The Auditor General has now proposed to cut down the Constitution Commissions by collapsing into one the Kenya National Human Rights Commission, the National Gender Inequality Commission, and the Commission on Administrative Justice.
Now, with respect to duplication of roles, the genesis of each entity should be visited. I mean, why did you want it in the first place? For instance, Commission on Administration of Justice, such questions should be asked.
The number of those commissioners are too many. At best, we can have a minimum of 3 commissioners per commission. Parliament needs to come in and evaluate the commissioners, whether any appointed commissioner is doing his work or her work for the job that she was employed.
The report by the 11-member team was sanctioned by the Budget Committee in February to look at socio-economic impact in implementing the constitution, with a view of relooking at the possibility of a referendum to amend any laws that were burdening the country financially.
The benefit of the constitution were both socio-political and economic. And now if you look at it, they have not come up with a clear cut.